Hi, my name is Ishita Dutta, a second year law student, currently interning at LEXIS and Company. And today I will be talking about a topic which is a grave concern, which is that if somebody tries to blackmail us by our photos online, so how do we deal with it? What is blackmail exactly? The word blackmail is used loosely in the society. And at the same time, many people are aware what it actually means. Generally, it is an act of coercion which involves in threatening to do something which one would prefer not to do if he or she was not pressurized in the situation. The pressure to do an act is intense because the perpetrator asks the victim to do something which he or she would refrain from doing so. The perpetrator may also blackmail the victim that he or she would share the sensitive information, which may include private photos, chats and videos, or any other form of data. The victim goes through intense psychological and emotional trauma and fails to act rationally in such situations, due to which his or her life may also be at stake. So what is the remedy to blackmail? No person would happily share private photos on social media platforms such as Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, where millions of users are active at the same time. And data transmits from one corner of the world to another corner of the world in seconds. But photos do get leaked, often as a ploy to take revenge from the person concerned. And this might get used for pornographic purposes and also completely shatters one's reputation in social life. What can be done in this case? What is the remedy exactly? Neutralize the threat. Try and neutralizing the threat that the perpetrator is trying to make. For example, the perpetrator may blackmail you that he or she would leak your private photos to your best friend. And then you must directly go to your best friend and tell him or her about your plight. It is an uncomfortable thing to do, but surely it is one way of avoiding it. Second would be calling the police. Dial 100 and tell the police officials about everything what you are going through. And the police officials will take your address, phone number, and also ask officials from the local police station near your house to meet you. And the police will help in tracking down the perpetrator via special tracking devices so that nothing is leaked at all. However, the police may also be insensitive and rude to you at times and may cause leakage of photos themselves during an investigation. Usually, when the police gets involved in such kind of matter, the perpetrator and his or her family are summoned to the police station concerned. His phones and laptops are also confiscated and he might be arrested too. So blackmailing with photos can also be a civil offense and a criminal offense in the Indian context. A lawyer might help the victim by filing a civil case, asking for an injunction from the court on the perpetrator. Once they are served with the notice, they also might get a little worried and play on the defensive or might stop from ever doing such an act again. However, if the situation is serious, then you as the victim must not refrain from filing a criminal case against the perpetrator, since innumerable provisions protect you from such kind of situation. What are the legal provisions? They might protect you from the blackmail. For example, Section 66E of the Information Technology Act of 2000, which is violation of privacy, this section penalizes the capturing or publishing of the image of a private area of any person without the consent. Privacy was recently elevated to the status of fundamental rights under Article 21 of the Constitution of India. This just shows how important privacy in all aspects of our life is. Second would be Section 67 of the Information Technology Act 2000, transmitting obscene electronic material. According to this section, anyone who uses any electronic means to publish any picture, video, audio, etc., which is capable of defaming a person, morally will be considered as a crime. And the person doing such an act will be punished with this imprisonment, which may extend up to 5 years with fine also. Section 67A of the Information and Technology Act of 2000, which is electronic material containing sexually explicit act. According to this section, whoever uses electronic means to publish or transmit any material which contains a sexually explicit act or conduct will be liable for imprisonment, which may extend up to 7 years, and also incur a fine. Section 67B of Information and Technology Act 2000, which covers child pornography. This section penalizes the publishing of obscene electronic material involving persons below the age of 18, who are also called minors. The POSCO Act also has provisions to protect the minors in this regard. Section 501 of the Indian Penal Code, which states about printing or engraving matter, is known to be defamatory if it injures the reputation of that person in public. Whoever prints or engraves any matter knowing or having a good reason to believe that such a matter is defamatory of any person, they shall be punished with a simple imprisonment up to a term which may extend to 2 years, or with fine, or with both. In conclusion, we can say blackmailing is a serious offence. Though not expressly defined under substantive laws in India, it needs to be reported quickly, since the intensity of the same could get serious and have extreme consequences in store for the victim and for his near and dear ones. Thank you so much.